Good morning everyone, how are you all? I hope all of you are fine. And how is your study going on? I hope you people are studying very nicely. So today let us start with the topic physical and chemical changes. So what is a physical change? The properties that we can visually observe, like color, okay? The properties that can be observed and specified, like color, hardness, rigidity, fluidity, density, melting point, boiling point, etc. are the physical properties. So what is a physical change? In case of physical changes, there will be no change in the composition. There will be no change in the chemical nature of the substance. For example, if you take water, liquid water, so what is the chemical substance present in water? It is H2O. Now, if you keep this liquid water in fridge, what happens? It will become ice, okay? But the chemical substance that is present in the ice is also H2O. That means in case of interconversion of states, like melting of solid ice to liquid water, the chemical composition remains same. Similarly, changing from liquid water to gaseous water also, the chemical substance present in liquid water is H2O and in gaseous water also it is H2O. That means that H2O is not getting changed to some other substance. This type of changes are called physical changes. That means there will be no change in the chemical composition. Similarly, dissolving sugar in water. If we dissolve sugar in water, what happens? That sugar and water only remains in that solution. The sugar will not get changed to some other substance. Am I clear to you? And it is a reversible process. That means we can reverse it. Now, what is a chemical change? Chemical change is also called chemical reaction. Is a process where it brings change in the chemical properties of matter. Okay, in physical change there is no chemical change or the chemical composition of the matter, but in chemical changes there will be chemical there will be change in the chemical properties of the matter. That means previously there will be some other substance, after the chemical changes or chemical reaction we will get some other substance. Am I clear? In chemical changes we always get a new substance, and in chemical changes one substance reacts with another to undergo a change in chemical composition, and it is an irreversible process. We cannot reverse it. Am I clear? For example, burning of paper. If we burn paper, what happens? We burn paper in presence of oxygen and it gives us the ashes of the paper. And rusting of iron. What happens in case of rusting of iron? Iron reacts with moisture present in the atmosphere and it forms a brown flaky powdery substances. So obviously you will see some changes in it, okay? Previously there will be some other type of substance, and after the chemical changes or chemical reaction you will get another substance. Am I clear? And what do you think, what type of changes takes place during burning a candle? If you burn a candle, what happens? It seems like candle is melting, so it is a physical change, but at the same time what is happening? Burning takes place in presence of oxygen. Am I clear? So chemical changes is also going on. So burning of candle is both physical and chemical changes. Many examples are given in your book regarding physical and chemical changes. Please go through it, you will understand. Now, types of pure substances. How many types of pure substances are there? On the basis of chemical composition, substances are classified as elements and compounds. Already you learned about about elements in class 8. So what is an element? Elements are the basic form of matter that we cannot broken down into simpler substance. That means it is the simplest substance, okay? And Robert Boyle was the first scientist to use the term element in 1661. There are three types of elements: metals, non-metals and metalloids. Let us learn some properties of metals. Metals are electropositive. Always you will get that metals are electropositive, like Na plus, okay, Ca2 plus, these all are metals. Metals are lustrous, that means they are very much shiny. And metals are generally silvery gray or golden yellow color. And metals conducts heat and electricity. Metals are ductile. Ductile means we can draw metal into thin wires. Metals are malleable. Malleable means we can make a thin sheets of metals. Metals are sonorous. That means it produces ringing sound, like the bells that is used in school. Okay. Some examples are sodium, magnesium, aluminium, lithium, gold, silver, copper, iron, potassium, mercury, etc. Okay, and mercury is the only metal that is liquid at room temperature. Otherwise, metals we get generally in the solid form. Now, let us learn about some properties of non-metals. Non-metals are electronegative. Metals are electropositive. Non-metals are electronegative. And they display variety of colors and they are not that much shiny. Metals are poor conductors of heat and electricity and they are not lustrous, non-sonorous and non-malleable. Some examples are hydrogen, oxygen, iodine, carbon, bromine, chlorine, etc. Now, what is a metalloids? Some elements have the properties that is in between metals and non-metals and these are called metalloids. For example, boron, silicon, germanium, etc. You have to remember these names. Now, what do you mean by compound? A compound is a substance composed of two or more elements chemically combined with one another in a fixed proportion. That means there will be chemical reactions in between two or more elements and they will chemically combine. This type of substance is called compound. For example, magnesium in presence of oxygen, it gives us magnesium oxide. Now, what is a mixture? In case of mixture, we will simply mix two or more substances and it will not chemically combine. It will not react. Am I clear? So, that is the difference between compound and mixture. So, let us see some properties of mixture. A mixture has variable composition. That means if you take iron nails and sulfur powder, you can take any amount of iron and sulfur and you can mix it to form a mixture. But in case of compound, there will be a fixed amount which will react and it will give us the compound. Am I clear? Okay. A mixture shows the properties of the constituent substances. That means if you make a mixture of iron and sulfur, it will show the properties of iron and sulfur in the mixture. You can see. And we can separate this constituents of mixture by physical processes. For example, if we make a mixture of iron and sulfur, we can separate iron by magnet, that is called magnetic separation. And if you want to separate sulfur from the mixture by adding carbon disulfide solution, you can separate sulfur because sulfur gets dissolved in carbon disulfide solution and we can separate sulfur and iron from the mixture. Okay. Now, some properties of compounds. Elements react to form new compounds. Okay, there will be chemical reaction and it will give us the product as compound. For example, this is a mixture, iron and sulfur. If you heat it, it will react and it will give us the compound. If you don't heat it, it will remain as mixture. Am I clear? Okay. The composition of each new substance is always fixed. That means the composition of this substance will be remain fixed. It will not change. But in case of mixture, it will change. The new substance has totally different properties. That means iron sulfide have totally different properties than that of iron and sulfur. Okay, it will not mix with the property of this iron present in iron sulfide is very much different from this iron and property of this sulfur present in iron sulfide is totally different from this sulfur. Am I clear? There will be no similarities, but in case of mixture, it has the same properties. Next, the new substance has totally different properties and the constituents can be separated only by chemical or electrochemical reactions. That is, by physical method we cannot separate. There has to be some other chemical or electrochemical reactions to separate them. Am I clear? Okay, this chapter is over. I am giving you one homework. Today, you people will write all the NCERT questions of chapter 2 in your copy. After that, I will explain when school will open or in the next class. Am I clear to you? So, you people will write all the NCERT questions, inside questions and exercise questions in your copy. Am I clear? If you find any problem, then you can ask.